Hello, everybody. So it's August 1st, meaning I have to show you what I have done during July. So first of all, the awesome Vicky hosted this Harry Potter color or Harry Potter color along and the marathon. I did not join in on that being live, but I did a picture. So I colored this guy, Draco Malfoy. So yeah, that is what I did for that Harry Potter color along. I think I hosted by the Sweet Vicky. So I have been working in my Tenderful Enchantment. Again, this is my book cover. Hope that this post does that will stop unless, or if not, then I have to turn it off. So I don't really have that many pages left, so I have been working in it all months. So I've actually done quite a lot, a lot of pictures. So I only have one picture left when after this. So hopefully I will be finishing this book during August, and that is awesome. So first out, I did this. Three houses, they are colored mostly with the Garaffa tint. And a little bit of the Lara Graduate. So that was that one. We did this one with ink tints and some acrylic paint for the skies. Hopefully you can see some of that shimmer if I do it like this, maybe. So there are videos showing how I colored this one with ink tints. That was so much fun. We did not this one I have done before. This one! We have a video about the or with this one as well, or at least the start where I show how I'm thinking with the light sources and stuff. No, but that was not it. This was the picture I did before. I'm so sorry. There are no videos with this one. But we will come to that. So I did this love bench. That is with ink tints and Lara Graduate as well. I love this purse. It's so cute. This is the one I am working with now, so I'm soon done with it. Not much left. But what oops, here comes my pencil. This one we did on a camera with the light sources showing or using our candle as a light source, and then I showed how I'm thinking when I'm coloring pictures who are getting darker and darker further out. So if I lift up, maybe you see it better, because it is night time for me now, so I don't have daylight anymore. Yeah, that was that. That's the last one there. So soon one more picture. I don't have much left, and then this that Tenderful Enchantment by Markova is over or done. That's gonna be awesome. Next book up, we did something from Nordiska Vesen by Johan Egerkrans. So we did on camera, we colored this giant, and I really love him, how he ended up we did him with the Graffiti tints as well, and some Lyra Graduate. So that was Nordiska Vesen. Next up, we worked in this awesome coloring book by Tim Jeffs, Intricate Ink Animals in Detail. This is volume 4. So on camera we did se. I believe we did though. Camera, let me see what picture it is. Yeah, we did this awesome. Oops, this sea turtle that has this sparkly shell. I really like him, and I love how his. If I can lift up that, you actually can see his eyelashes. Look at, he's so cute. And the light actually really flashes him out, so he's a little bit darker. Really, I think. Yeah. Anyways, that was Intricate Ink Animals, a coloring book by Tim Jeffs. And I love Tim Jeffs. I've done a lot of him. I got some new copics, so I kept on working in my forest school. Forest school one is this by Aeppol. And how I'm working in this book is quite simple. I started on the first page, and then I have been working my way throughout the book. So this is a page that I did this month with copics. So next up is this bathing picture. So yeah, so this is my copic work for this month. And we have, of course, one of another one of my favorite books is Mysteria by Anastasia, Elly, and Colorbook. She's an amazing artist. She came out with Nocturne as well, but I don't have that. Was it this one we actually have done for? I believe that it was this. I love her, my little butterfly. I used the Norwegian Luving butterfly as a reference, because they come in like blue and garden shades. So she is colored with the polychromos and I graduate. And this actually fell off, but so that was Mysteria by Anastasia Elly Koldareva. I only did one picture, yeah. That one. July has been a month where I have been so busy. Kids at home, and it's in summertime, so we have been out bathing, we have been having fun. So I really haven't been home that much, and of course birthday and everything came up, and I also got this book as a gift, The Ink House by Rory Dobner. So I have been working a little bit now and then, or when I could, in this book. So I have done this first page that I did with Inktense. And I just call it the small butterflies and watch here. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I should try to. It will only flashes out if I lift it up. So I haven't really done that much. I have colored this one mouse, the corner down here. It's very dark down the corner. Maybe if I like that, maybe. Yeah. There you can see him. He's cute. Let's see. What have I done? Yeah, I did these two pages as well. This one, I'm so happy with it. And I really love this book because several pages have like small images like these two butterflies. And then I actually can color and enjoy myself with these ones and just add something easy in the background, and the page is actually done. Then I feel that I have actually done something, and not like Mysteria where I can work 3, 4, 5 days on one picture and really not see that I have done any anything. Calarabella I colored. But I really love that this book has these small ones as well. So when you don't have time for a big one, you can just find something small and easy here. I did this one. That one I just finish a sky for. So let's see, I have. I think I did one more. Yeah, because I did this cheetah. Look at this guy. Isn't he awesome? Charlie Cheetah. So I haven't taken pictures and posted them on Insta yet. But I will do that. So I've done that. Cheetah, I don't think there's anything more I should have made now, because this book I've had only for a week or so. Yeah, so that was that. That was the ink house. Oops, sorry. And of course we have my loose pages. So let me see, where is this? This month is not really that much, and I have been working with very different mediums really. So this is pastels. I have used my Carbotello pastels. I want to try to lift up. If you can see his eyes, how gorgeous they are. Blue eyes. They are amazing. So I'm so happy with him, finally, because I had a really hard time making or getting him like light enough, and then he got too light, and then I have to darken him, and then he got too dark, and yeah, so he was a challenge for sure. I also did, oh, I forgot to tell you, this is by Tim Jeffs, it's from the endangered species book that you can buy out of Etsy. So this is a Tim Jeffs, and this is a Tim Jeffs as well, also with the Carbotello pastels. I had so much fun doing him. And my colors really doesn't show quite well. Maybe if I lower that one a little bit, maybe something like that. Oops. Yeah, okay, there it is. Look at them, isn't he cute? I think he's so adorable. And it was so much fun working with him and the pastels. I really love my Carbotello pastel pencils. Another one from Tim Jeffs. This is the Javan Rai Nosaurus. It's a Nature's Own Unicorns. The real unicorn, so of course I sparkled up his horn, and I did her pink or purplish, so but I still wanted to keep it some kind of realistic, even if she's pink. She is done in watercolors actually. Another one in watercolors is the Amur leopard. All of this is from the endangered species book that you can get on Etsy by Tim Jeffs. So this is my Amur leopard. I'm really happy with him as well. And of course doing fur with watercolors, oh my god, that takes time. But I'm really happy with the background and his colors and stuff. So I think I did a good job with all those and animals. I used to stay away from any animals because they had fur, and then I came to a point where I said that no, come on, you can learn fur. So I just jumped into it, and finally, it's functioning well enough. So this is a picture that I have done in Copics, another Copic work. This was actually made by Suus, which is Caroline colored by Caroline is her I channel, her daughter, Suus, made this so we could color it. And it is my very first kind of punk angel or fairy, punk fairy. So that was so much fun. And watercolors only done two, and like I said, this month have been with other mediums and other stuff, and I have actually done a lot of acrylic pouring, but I won't show you those. So I did this one in watercolors. Waves are actually very hard to do, so I think that I have to redo this at one point. I love my sky. I think that's awesome, and I also put in some shiny paints on top in every of my pictures, or not everyone, but I have them in almost every picture. I don't know if you actually can see it coming through a little bit on this or on these ones, but. So I made both of these following a tutorial by the Robin Shiba. He is awesome, so I love following him. And I added some birds and stuff, so I can't really do exactly what he does, but close enough. Anyways, that was the last picture from me from July 2019. So I hope that you enjoyed this, and I will be back in a month showing you what I have been doing during August. Hopefully I get to do a little bit more. So until then, take care, color something, and have fun. Enjoy yourself, and I will see you all around. Bye!
Det är en stor.